Well, good afternoon and welcome to yet another new edition of the New Old Show. We are back live in the studio. We took a couple weeks off and went to Modesto and spent 2 weeks on the water slides. No, that's a lie. That isn't what we did. But we were not here. So we replayed some greatest hits shows from the past. And today we are back on the New Old Show. Of course, the New Old Show is where we're doing what we used to do when we started the radio station. We started the show when the radio station started back 20 years ago, coming up next year. And so we bring a musician in here and torment them for an hour to live their past and play a few tunes. And today we are delighted to have, and like if I can, it's, see, I have a problem with my eyes. I can see, I need like three different sets of glasses. I finally have just admitted I need multiple sets of glasses. So I got to see what mic we're on here. Today we have Randall Burrows live in the studio with us. Randall, how you doing?
Good. Randy is fine.
Yeah, Randy, that was the first question I was going to ask, because I see Randall all over and I see Randy, and I never know, you know, what is the problem. I mean, people, you know, if somebody calls me Jim, it's someone that I knew when I was in junior high, because about high school, I didn't give me the name, but some girls decided I was going to be James.
Okay.
And they started calling me, I think it was to make fun of me. You know, there was like, to poke fun, or, you know, to, he's going to hate this, let's call him James. And it just kind of stuck. So that's how I became that. So Randy is fine.
Yeah. I Randy Burrows was taken on Facebook, so I put Randall. So now I can sort of tell who knows me and who doesn't, because if they call me Randall.
Yeah. When I was doing the post last night, it's funny because on my personal page, if I'm friends with people, typically people like you, if I typed in Randy Burrows, you come up first, and then all the other Randy Burrows do. But on the show page, I don't know if you're following the show or how that actually works, but I typed in Randy Burrows and all the Randy Burrows showed up and none of them had the icon that was you.
Right.
So I had to actually publish the post and then go back and find you. And then the show page never actually let me put your link in there. I don't know if maybe your profile, your personal profile or your music profile has a thing that says don't let pages tag me
banned.
I don't know. I tried real hard. So I threw it out on my personal page and tagged you in there.
I don't take it personally.
Okay, good. Because there are people who take the Facebook very personally.
Right.
I heard you say this and that about me on Facebook. It's like, it's Facebook, you know? No, it was. They were joking. I don't even know this person. Anyway, that's not why we're here. Now we're going to touch bases a little bit about what you're doing here in town. But when did you start playing music? What made you decide I want to be a musician?
Well, I have sort of two phases of my life in music. The first was when I was very young, about 11 years old, mm-hmm. and started playing drums.
Yeah.
And I live with my cousin Mike, who was a terrific guitar player, my age exactly. We were like a month apart, and we were pretty close, like brothers. And he was a phenomenal musician. He was a savant.
Uh-huh.
And so he started playing guitar, and it was at a time when everybody wanted to be in a band. So I said, if you're going to play guitar, I'll play drums, and we'll start a band.
Right.
And that's what we did. And so I played drums through junior high school and high school, a little bit into college, but mostly by the time I was out of high school, I was done. And then I put it down for a long, long time. I went off and did other things and worked and had a family and all that. And but about, I don't know, maybe 10, 12 years ago, I thought to myself, when was the best time I had in my life? It was playing music.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so I literally ordered a guitar off the internet and... And never played
as
a
one,
chord. Never,
as one would.
Yeah, exactly. With a lot of recommendation. And just started playing, you know, started playing a little guitar, trying to learn how to play. But it's harder when you're in your 50s, you know. It's not...
Well, back when you were 11, what inspired you? I mean, just what type of music were you listening to back then?
So I grew up in Marysville, California, which was a town, I think, a lot like Sonoma. You know, it's a farming community, smaller town, probably 10 to 15,000 people then. Mm-hmm. And there were an unbelievable number of bands and really talented musicians. Everybody had a band in their garage. And I think the Beatles probably prompted a lot of that. People started playing
music. Was that about the era?
Yes. Yeah.
So did you see the Beatles on Ed Sullivan?
The Beatles on Ed Sullivan.
I missed all that.
Yeah.
For whatever reason, I missed the Beatles entirely. The first Beatles 45 I ever bought was the last one they ever released, The Long and Winding Road. And then I traded it to the guy across the street for for Venus by the Shocking Blue.
Right.
So I missed the Beatles completely. So that was not my story. But people of our generation, as it were, so many were influenced by the Beatles. So you saw the Beatles and thought, this might be a cool thing to do.
Right. And I had a couple of twin cousins who were about 4 years older, and they were teenagers at that point. And so they constantly had the 45s on their on their little Montgomery Ward one speaker, stereo.
Open it up and there's
open
a speaker
it up,
there.
Yeah, and put down the needle. And and so we listened to that, and we listened to local AM radio and KFRC.
You got KFRC all the way up there, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I guess Maryville's not that far away from here.
No, it's about 100 miles.
And once you hit that Central Valley, that radio signal spreads all over.
Exactly. So
you're playing cover music or just, you know, you didn't write any songs back then.
No, I wasn't a songwriter and I was a sort of a mediocre drummer, to the truth be told.
Oh, right. You were the drummer then. Well, you know, everybody wanted to be the drummer. I know I wanted to be a drummer, but my parents, you know, that wasn't going to happen. But actually sitting down and playing drums, I realized you really need to be coordinated here.
Right.
this is more than just banging sticks on things. It took less coordination to play guitar, it seemed like. And so you got all the way through high school in those early times.
Yeah, we played
gigged out
junior high dances and then high school dances.
What was the name of those bands?
God, it was in a time when I think we had a different name every week.
Oh, right.
Yeah, so.
We're the Avengers this week.
Yeah, exactly.
Next week, you're the Pyramids.
We're the Fire, the Sacred Fire.
Arnold
Ziffel was one of the bands.
Arnold Ziffel? When there was no Arnold in the band.
No, of course not. It was named after the pig in Green Acres, actually.
Oh, right. By the way, which one's pink?
So we went through a lot of different names. And it was, you know, it would be sort of like you were talking about earlier, which is whoever was available that weekend, sometimes we get together and play. But it was fun. It was really fun. And, you know, we wanted to meet girls, and that was part of it.
It's funny. It's that I was interviewing, I may have told this story before, for the people who have listened more than once. I on the old show, I used to bring, you know, people in and like this. And I'd say, what got you started playing music? And without even hesitation, he looked at me and said, there's only one reason why we're all doing this. I was like, you're right. So I'm not going to out him, but he has another show on the station.
I'll admit it.
You know, if you can't afford a Camaro, you can always play guitar. You know?
Right. But I went off to college and
didn't really play music.
Can't really
in college.
Take your drums off your dorm room.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So that sort of shut that down for a long time. And I stayed interested.
It's still been a drummer this entire time.
Never played a guitar. No.
And roll the clock forward, and now you've had kids. The kids are older, and
I'm on the back nine.
Look in the back nine. Yeah. Me too. Whether it's hole 14 or hole 18
or
17, I'm not sure which one I'm on either. But we're definitely we've made the turn.
Yeah.
You said the best time of my life was playing music. Just decided guitar sounds easier than drums, or it sounds like a less of an investment, or
and I always wanted to be out in front when you're the drummer. Like everybody wants to be the drummer, but the drummer always wants to be out front. So
right. I played in the band where the drummer actually was out front and still is, and you probably have seen them.
And guitar is something you can do by yourself. So I was just down alone in my basement with my guitar, looking up chords on the internet, and so that was. If I would have gone back to drums, I would have had to find a band and all. So this was just a more direct line to play music.
Well, now what songs? We're here live in the studio with Randy Burrows here on 91.3 KSBY FM Sonoma, the new old show. I'm your host, James Marshall Berry. Now, when you started learning guitar, who were some of your inspirations? I mean, who did you say, man, I want to learn how to play this song?
You know, I remember almost to the day pulling up in front of my house and Wilco came on. It was, I think, the first Wilco album, the AM album.
Yeah.
And they were playing Passenger Side, which is, which I thought, hey, you know, that had a little bit of a country sound to it and it had a little humor in it. And I thought, I like that. And so Wilco was, Jeff Tweedy was an early, an early influence on me. You know, I always, always liked John Prine. And, so that was, so I listened to a lot of John Prine, but I, you know, I listened to a lot of country rock and, a lot of different music, but yeah, Jeff Tweedy was a big early influence and got me back into guitar.
So the first, you went out and got home and learned that song? Is that kind of the way it went, or?
Yeah, it was a little slower than that.
It took more than a day? Is that what you're saying?
It took me more than a day, but that got me into it, and I started, you know, taking a couple lessons, and...
From here, local here in town?
Yeah, I mean, my first teacher here in town was Adam Trum.
Oh, and so, good old Adam. We've had... I think we've had Adam in here on the show. No, we had Josh.
Right.
Yeah, we had Adam and Jack. I have not had Adam in here solo. We had the had Wolf Run in here.
So Adam gave me my early lessons, and now Josh gives me my later lessons. So
Josh is quite a player. We had him in just a while back.
I listened to that show.
The whole story of how we ended up with Mazzy Star, you know, being at the music store. I mean, what, you know.
Yeah,
that's being at the right place at the
right
time.
What are the chances, right?
So so you play pedal steel? Yes, I do.
Yeah.
You want to tour with us? Yeah. Yes, I do.
And so I planned a couple of open mics. And
now, where do they have? Maybe, well, you do an open mic. We're going to talk a little bit about that at the Starling. But where were their open mics?
Well, I lived in Kenwood at the time, and we used to do an open mic at the Kenwood Depot.
Oh yeah, with
once a month with Guy. I can't remember Guy's last name.
Guy. Yeah, what was his name?
Guy and Monty.
And they had the open mic. Now who else might have been there? Jay Gamble probably.
You know who was there? Was John Williams and his mom. His mom played there all the time. Yeah. Yeah,
his mom's quite a singer.
She's got a great repertoire too.
She has a lot of those old country songs that many have forgotten.
And she's got the sound down.
Oh, she does.
Sounds like those old country.
She really.
Songs.
And I've been trying to get John Williams in here. He's not good with the technology. I mean, I'll send him an email and I'll hear back 6 weeks later or something. You know. And I'm not good.
To clear space for him. Though. He likes to move around.
I know. He's. You know, and I'm not good with the phone. For whatever reason, I'm horrible at phone. I answering phone, voicemails. I used to be good at it. I don't know. Now I get a voicemail, I listen to it, and I forget it ever happened, which is bad.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to get John Williams in here. In fact, John, if you're out there, if you're listening.
He's not shy, I'm sure.
I had a cancellation for next week that I had booked. So next week is open.
And, if you know John, call him, please.
I may after the show, I may tag you for some people. You know plenty of people.
Oh, sure.
That I'd love to get in here. And I, you know, after being, you know, I wrote the column, the music column for a long time, and I was up to my ears in the whole thing. And now after not doing it for 5 or 6 years, I there's a circle of people that I know, but I've been through them all. And I really want to bring new talent and people from out of the area. I want to bring in people from Petaluma, Napa, Santa Rosa in. We're going to have Clementine Darling in
in
a couple weeks.
And I
know who she is. I've heard her online. I don't know a single thing about her. So she was very happy to come on over. So I want to do a lot of that kind of stuff. So I may hit you up on that. We're going to take a quick break and hear for a word or two from our sponsors. Of course, you can also be a sponsor by pointing your browser to ksvy.org. We are community radio here, and we are only funded through our sponsors. We don't have big NPR checks or Hewlett-Packard or Coca-Cola writing grants to us. We'd like that. If you're a grant writer, we'd like to talk to you also. We'll even give you a percentage of the money you get us because there's just not enough of us here. But if you would like to become a sponsor or you'd like to become a someone that supports the cause, you can donate as little as $20 a month, monthly basis, one time. Point your browser to ksvy.org and there's lots of room and spaces. There's links and buttons at the top that will take you to where you need to go to find out more about that. And we have an event coming up. Hang on. I have to find this whole thing. Oh, now here's where the glasses things come in. I'm wearing my, I can see the freeway sign glasses, but they aren't the you can read the words in front of you glasses. In case you did not know, we are presenting a concert, the first of what we hope is many. For years, personally, I've been hoping that Sebastiani Theater would be a music venue similar to the Mystic or something like that. And then for years and years, it had to be movies for a number of reasons. I don't know what has changed, but they are starting to do concerts. We had a benefit for Maui just last Saturday in town here with about six or seven different bands. They did a Ray Charles tribute thing on Sunday. And we are having Swinging Out West, and it's a benefit here for Sonoma Community Radio. We've got Tommy Thompson. We've got J. Dub and Dino. We have Helen Mead from Napa. We have Gary Felder, and I forget the other person's name because it's not written down here in front of me. Gary does cowboy poetry. If you've never heard Gary perform cowboy poetry, that's really something. And, of course, Tommy, and then an all-star jam at the end, and I'm sure I've left some people out here. T-Luke. T-Luke and the Tight Suits are going to be there as well. So the concert is Sunday, November 26th. It's that Sunday after Thanksgiving, and it's an afternoon. It's 2 to 6. You can still catch a little football in the morning and then go downtown and support the local radio station at the historic Sebastiani Theater. Tickets are going fast, so if you point your browser to ksvy.org, you can get to the ticket links as well. We'll have a silent auction where there'll be a variety of unique things that you can't get anywhere else, I'm sure. And some fine wine sales that's going to benefit the organization here. And, of course, all of that is tax deductible. And more details. It says live up on the other side. Here's a mountain of words that I'm never going to read. Anyway, if you point your browser to ksvy.org, you can find out more about that. But in the meantime, without any further ado, let's hear from our sponsors. And it's supposed to say now back to my show, but it doesn't. But that's what I was talking about, the Dave Aguilar thing there. Dave, thank Dave for clearly he came down here to the studio to record that spot. And thank you, Dave, for participating. And Dave Aguilar will be there. If you've not ever seen Dave, now is your chance. And if you have seen Dave, you'll know you'll want to see him again because him and his act are that good. Anyway, we're back here live in the studio today with Randy Burrows, learning a little bit more about Randy and what he's done and what he has been. And he's remembered the name of that first band. What was that first band?
If my cousin Mike is out there listening, he'll remember that it was Napoleon and the Tyrants.
Napoleon and the Tyrants.
Yeah, we even had some skin-tight pants. We sort of modeled ourselves after Paul Revere and the Raiders.
Uh-huh.
So we had costumes and the whole thing.
Now, Paul Revere and the Raiders, they had the hit, what was it, Cherokee Nation or Indian Reservation?
Cherokee Nation. They had Kicks Keep Getting Harder to Find.
Oh, were they the Kicks Keep?
Yeah.
Okay,
and they also did a version of Louie Louie that wasn't the most popular one, but they were sort of net. There's an interesting article about this, but the Kingsmen and the Raiders recorded that song almost the same day. And the Kingsmen were the ones that made it famous.
But neither of them wrote it, though, right?
Right.
Somebody else had written it years before. And it never did anything. And then, and I guess the Kingsmen, they had an FBI file on them because they thought there was some kind of subversive lyrics
some
in
message
there.
Message in the lyrics.
Because nobody
exactly
could understand what they were saying. And really, the guy was probably just loaded and mumbling, was probably the story. But
there's a very good podcast called The History of Rock in 500 Songs. And he does a whole episode on that very topic.
Wow.
And
just
so
on
I recommend
song.
That to anybody that's really into music, especially in that era.
Wow. Yeah. So it's the history of rock.
In 500 songs.
So if you're not listening to this podcast, you can go find the history of rock out there.
Yeah.
So before we learn a little bit more about you, you've got your guitar.
Right.
Now, is that the one you bought on the internet?
No. I've come a long way.
I still
have that one.
And what was that one?
That was a Zager. And if you remember
Zager
and Evans, in the year 25,
yeah,
25.
Yeah,
remember
yeah,
that song?
I do remember that.
Well, Denny Zager became a guitar, a luthier,
uh-huh,
I guess.
Right.
And he advertised his guitar as an easy play guitar. And I thought, well, I need to learn as easily as I possibly can. So I've still got the guitar and it still sounds pretty good.
What was easy about it?
I think the action was good. The neck was smaller.
Oh, a little tighter.
Yeah, long. Yeah. And the sound, it still sounds pretty good.
Nice.
Yeah, I still
nice.
Play it.
Now, what do you got there?
This is a Martin.
Oh.
OM.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Very nice. I can see that.
From the Tall Toad.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. It's shocking. That's where mine is. I went over. I played 5 Martins and, spent a good couple hours playing.
Right.
I'm like, God, I like this one. I like this one. Finally, I settled on one. It's like, you know what? This is the one. It makes that clumping sound, the dunk, like the Neil Young sound. I'm all, this is the most expensive one, isn't it? And they're like, yeah.
Yeah, of course it is, yeah. But you sort of know. The minute, I played probably 30 guitars over the course of 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And when you get the one that you like, you know it.
It was the one I kept coming back to. It's like, this is the one I have to leave with.
Yeah, exactly.
Doesn't matter how much it is, it's going to be. Yeah. So, you do original songs and cover songs.
I do an occasional cover song.
Oh, so you're mostly originals.
Almost all originals. In
really?
Fact, when I play out, it's seldom that I play more than a cover or two, just because I figure there are not a lot of people, including the original artists, who can play their songs better than I can. But nobody can play my songs better than I can because they don't know them, right?
No, well, no.
So
no, they don't.
I've cornered the market on my songs.
Oh, well, and that's a good market to corner.
But, yeah, they say it takes 100, you got to write about 100 songs to write a good one. And I just hit my 100th of
really?
The ones that I've kept.
Wow.
And so I'm hoping the next song is going to be the good one. Right?
I dare to say you probably have a couple good ones that you're not bragging about. But what are we going to hear right now?
Well, this is sort of an early song. My early, none of them are old. This is maybe 4 or 5 years old. This is a song that it sort of stemmed from being at open mic, and we used to do a thing called live band karaoke over the
Starlight. Oh, yeah, yeah.
And
John's thing.
We'd sometimes hear the same songs over and over. And one day, Liz, who was behind the bar over there, and one of the owners of the Starlight, said, gosh, if I hear Angel from Montgomery one more time.
Oh, I took it off my set list. mainly because I'm even though John Prine wrote it, it sounds so much better when Bonnie Raitt's version is great. John's great version is great too.
Yeah, and there's some songs you hear over and over, and so that sort of got me thinking, and it got me thinking about a woman I knew from high school that tried to go off and become a country singer, and you always hear about the people that make it, but you don't really hear a lot about the people that don't make it, and all the trials and tribulations. So this is called Karaoke Cowgirl, and it's actually Jenny Purcell does this song.
Oh, really?
And she does it a lot better than me. Her voice is a lot better than mine.
I love playing with Jenny. I love listening to Jenny.
She's terrific.
I keep trying to get her in here. And I don't know if I'm the problem or if I just haven't connected with her. Because she said she wanted to. And I'm thinking, well, why haven't we done this yet?
Yeah.
So I'll have to connect with her as well. So she's on my list too. John Williams, Jenny Purcell.
Yeah.
And people that I don't know about yet that I'll hear from you in a minute. We're here live with Randy Burrows in the studio. We're going to hear Karaoke Cowgirl here on 91.3.
Here we go. Well, if she had a dime for every time that someone told her, oh, you're way too good to be wasted here, she'd be down the road before another day older. In her rear view, see this dead town disappear. But it's this days in lounge, 2 nights a week. Wrangling drunks and bachelorettes for spotty tips, watered down drinks. Oh, and 2 guaranteed 15-minute sets. She was gonna be the next big thing in Nashville. Gonna ride 'em like Loretta, gonna sing 'em like Patsy Cline. That's just a karaoke cowgirl, and it's Angel from Montgomery one more time.
At 10 years old, she had set her world on fire. Town shows and county fairs. Daddy tuned her guitar, drove the country squire. Mama made her outfits, did her hair. Then 17, got her hopes high. First prize meant a deal with the record man. She packed her songs, waved her folks by. From the way back of an Econoline van. She was gonna be the next big thing in Nashville. Gonna ride them like Loretta, gonna sing them like Patsy Cline. Now she's just a karaoke cowgirl, and it's Tennessee whiskey one more time. Well, her 20s, they were full of promise. Mostly from men twice her age, swearing she'd break through. She's pretty sure they stopped being honest. Told herself she was using them too. The worth years and the miles rolled by swiftly. Suddenly she's pushing 50. Dreams run aground. Then surrender's tide swept her to the house her parents left her. Part of her relief they weren't around. Tuesdays and Fridays now she earns her 30 minutes just to sing somebody else's songs. She's pretty sure she's learned her limits. Reckons this must be right where she belongs. She was gonna be the next big thing in Nashville. Gonna ride them like Loretta, gonna sing them like Patsy Cline. Now she's just a karaoke cowgirl, and it's I Fall to Pieces One More Time. Now she's just a karaoke cowgirl, and it's I Fall to Pieces One More Time.
Karaoke Cowgirl, live in the studio. Randy Burrows here with us on 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma. I am your host, James Marshall Berry. Now, when did you discover that you could sing? About the same time you figured out you could play guitar?
That discovery has been yet to be made.
No, you're doing all right.
I'm working on it. You know, it's one of those things. The good news
not everybody can sing and play.
You can get better at it. I didn't. And I've taken a couple lessons, but mostly just repetition. Just working on it. And
some people I know that they can't even carry a note, and but they did eventually become the ability to sing. But when you say I just decided to play guitar, did you decide to sing at the same time?
I think I started out just trying to learn songs that I liked and sing along with them. I like to sing. And then I started writing songs, and I figured if I was going to write a song, I was going to have to sing it. So I just leapt into it with both feet.
Yeah. Now, do you record the tunes and listen back and decide what you like and what you don't like?
I do.
It makes me crazy. I cannot listen to my own voice.
It's really hard. I'm trying to make an album right now. I think Josh is more or less the producer working on it, Josh Yenne.
Right. Yeah.
And he told me, going into this, look, you're not going to like what you hear from yourself. And
no.
You know, and
no, it's horrifying.
100% accurate. Yeah. Yeah. So we're working on an album of all my songs. And that's both fun and scary and disturbing, you know.
Yeah. Now, who are your inspirations when we're going to hear a couple more tunes from you in a bit.
Yeah.
But who are your inspirations? When you're writing a song, you know, is it just you or you think, okay, which comes first? I mean, are you more of a, I'm going to write this melody guy and then come up with words, or you got words in your mind and you wrap the music around the words?
Yeah, people will tell you can do it any way, and sometimes you do it both ways.
Right.
But I'm mostly a lyrics guy first. And so I really like songs with a little bit of humor, a little tongue-in-cheek. So John Prine, Todd Snider, Guy Clark to some degree, Robert Earl Keen, those were sort of my songwriting heroes. But there's a lot of good songwriters out there now, you know, to listen to. There's a guy named Adam Carroll, if you get a chance to hear him. He's got funny songs that are good. And a guy named Gabe Lee out of Nashville. And I think John Prine and Todd Snider were my North Stars, I think, looking at as I was trying to write songs. And, you know, I used to love Roger Miller when I was a kid. You know,
yeah.
And he
could
do that.
I when I was a kid, that was on the radio. It was on one of the stations we were allowed to listen to. Now, do you do poetry as well?
I don't do poetry, no.
So how do you come up with words? I've never been a good songwriter. I've written some of the most horrible songs known to man, and I quit in the 80s. So how do you just write a story then?
I pretty much, most of my songs are story songs, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and I'm trying to make them sort of have people pay attention. So it helps to make them laugh a little bit if you can. Not all my songs. Mm-hmm. That's probably one of my most serious songs that I just played.
Right.
Yeah. And
which we had a little tongue-in-cheek action.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So So that's what I'm going for. I'm trying to be the West Coast Californian poor cousin to John Prine.
There you go. Well, we're going to take a quick break here on 91.3 KSBY FM Sonoma. Going to hear some of our sponsors. And once again, if you do hear, you hear these sponsor mentions throughout the day, if you come across or you go to patronize one of our sponsors, find the owner or find the person behind it and say, hey, you know, I heard your ad. I heard your sponsor on KSVY Radio. Thank you for supporting community radio. By thanking them, they realize that, hey, people are digging what we're doing, and it just helps to the cause. It gives everybody a warm, fuzzy feeling. And come on now, who doesn't like a warm, fuzzy feeling now? So we're going to, so if you hear from if you hear these sponsors, well, I think one of them is Sonoma Valley Hospital. That's typically in my 40, I get this, I get a health moment. And as I joke, I need a little bit more than a moment at this point in my life. I might need a health hour, I'm not sure. But anyway, if you do hear from our sponsors, and if you want to become one, once again, point your browser to ksvy.org. There's all kinds of interesting information there, as well as tickets to the Swinging Out West event. And before I talk my way right out of everything, we're going to hear from our And now back to the New Old Show with your host, James Marshall Berry. That's what's supposed to be right there. That's supposed to be my re-intro to the show. But it hasn't happened, and I don't know. And usually it's the amazing Jeff Gilbert that does it. And I know I complain about this all the time, but I'm one of those guys. So we're not going to complain about that anymore. We are live here in the studio with Randy Burrows, and we're getting to know a little bit about him and listen to some of his songs. And before we get into more tunes, now you said you learned at open mics at the Depot up there in Kenwood and other places, and now
a Hot Monk here in town.
On the Wednesdays with Matt.
Yeah, with
Matt's
that, yeah.
Matt is a
great guy.
He plays keyboards in one of my acts. One of the most amazing keyboard players.
Yeah, he's really good.
So much energy. He's so fun to play with.
Yeah.
You laugh sometimes watching him play because he's just so good. But, you know, and now you host your own open mic.
I do.
How did that happen?
Well, I was over at one of Matt's open mics at the Hot Monk in Sonoma, and I And I was driving home, and I saw that the Starling had just opened.
Uh-huh.
And I stopped in there to get a hot dog. And I was.
I've heard about the hot dog.
Yeah, and I talked to Liz, who I just met maybe one time before.
Uh-huh.
And I said, yeah, I've been over to an open mic. And she said, well, we'd like to have an open mic. And I said, I'll host it. And that's literally how it came about.
Having never done an open mic or hosted one.
Never hosted one, and then never having had one. And we started that, and that's, we're coming up on the seventh anniversary of that.
7 years?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why do I think that's only been the last 2 or 3 years?
No, well, it's come together. I mean, it's been consistent. I mean, it's had different iterations. But I've now got some regulars that are always there, and I've got some really good talent, and we get some.
Well, I've seen some Facebook stuff,
yeah.
And I've made it to a couple of them. I don't frequent bars as often as I used to since I quit drinking 6 years ago. So, you know, I mean, I still like to go to bars. I like the concept of bars I like to hang out in them. But after a while, it's like, okay, well, I can have soda water at my house and not pay $4. How do you run the open mic? Do people sign up before?
I mean, I try to get people to sign up before just because it saves me a lot of anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
Wondering if I'm going to have a full lineup that night. Now, that hasn't been a problem for quite a while. I'm usually overbooked. But it's helpful to me. And then I can tell people, I can give them a rough idea of when they're going to play so they don't have to come and sit there. In some places, you've got to go an hour before and sign up.
You got to sign up, and you've got to sit there.
Sharp elbows, and it's sort of unseemly. But I can generally give people a pretty good idea within a half an hour of when they're going to play.
Now, how often do you do it? Is it
just once a month?
Once a month.
Once a month.
Almost sounds like the demand would require, but then it'd require you showing up a little.
Well, that's the that would be the main issue. And I'm not sure that I want to test how, you know, if there's more demand. I sort of like where we are right now.
Yeah. So. Well, and then John's thing too. Do you work with John he's not doing live band karaoke there much anymore, is he?
No, they've moved that
down to
places.
Trek in Nevada
sort
or
of
something.
Outgrew the songs.
Oh, did it?
Song.
It was that big, huh?
Yeah, John and I sort of concocted that idea one day.
That's a great idea, and I John's got so much energy. I've been in bands with him. Great bass player too.
Yeah. And he does a lot for the community.
He does a lot for the music, a ton for the music community. I'm always joking that I can't get a hold of John. He's got five band. He's got five rehearsals today, you know, or something along those lines.
he's got four different bands and five rehearsals.
I can't keep track of him. Yeah. He's worse than I was, and he's older than me, which is really. And he has all his hair, so I'm just mad at him for a number of reasons. But I love him. But let's get to another tune before we run out of time.
Okay.
So we got about 10 more minutes here.
Okay.
Where we
let me give you. This is another fairly early song, but this is one that. I don't know. It people like it. We had a labradoodle. That was my best friend, and I lost him a couple years ago.
Oh, sorry.
But
I still cry about my cat.
But anyway, he was like the only thing that our family agreed on. But he was a little imperious. I always thought he was a little better than we were.
Oh, I don't doubt it. My cat does. One we got left.
Yeah, but my son would say, "Hey, Dad," this dog. He was a labradoodle, and his name was Crouton. And my son would say, "Wouldn't it be great if Crouton could talk, Dad?" And I'd say, "Yeah, but what if the only words he could say were Heil Hitler?"
You know? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Of course,
he probably wouldn't mean it.
My son was 8 and didn't get that joke. And so,
no.
You know. And so. This is a lot of songs that I write are sort of like "Be careful what you ask for" songs, and this comes in that theme. So this is called "If My Dog Could Talk."
Randy Burrows live here on 91.3 KSVY FM.
If my dog could talk, what would he say? Would he tell me I've been standing in his way? Would he call his dog friends on his dog cell phone? Gossip about the things I do when I think I'm all alone. Well, he's part poodle, so maybe he'd speak French. Sneered down his snout at me while smoking cigarettes. Would he speak to me? Would he give me the time of day? If my dog could talk, what would he say? And if my dog could sing, what would be his song? Would he memorize the words or always get some wrong? Is he a tenor? or a baritone? Would he join a dog boy band or go out on his own? Would he have a repertoire that I could be proud of? Or just keep singing that one song about muskrat love? Would he let me sing with him or tell me to softly hum along? If my dog could sing, would it be his song? Well, some thoughts should not be spoken. Some spells should not be broken. Sometimes better not to know. Some bears don't need poking. Some dogs should not be woken. Maybe I'll just stick with the status quo. If my dog were a person, who would he be? More like Nelson Mandela or Sean Hannity? Would he marry young, get divorced, have a midlife crisis, buy himself a Porsche? Would he vote the Reds, the Blues, or the Greens? Join the Hare Krishnas or maybe the Marines? Would we be friends or is he out of my league? If my dog were a person, who would he be? And if my dog could talk, would he talk to me?
If my dog could talk. Live in the studio here with Randy Burrows here on 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma. We had Josh in here, and right. there's some parallels there. That's the kind of song Josh would write. I can almost hear.
Yep. He's definitely been an influence on me. Yeah, and I sort of got serious about songwriting maybe four or five years ago now. It's been, I was doing an open mic over at Starling, and Adam Traum and Dale Geis came in.
Oh, yeah, good Dale. I remember Dale, we've played before.
Yeah, and I played a couple of my original songs, and so they invited me to join their songwriting group.
Oh, right.
And then later, Josh joined that group, and so, and Dale's, of course, moved away.
He's back east now.
But he may be listening today for all I know. So Adam and Josh and Benton Vaughn and Dave Hooper and I, we have our songwriting group. In fact, we're meeting tonight.
Ah.
We meet once a month. You got to bring in a song and play.
I have band practice tonight. It's not a songwriting group. We're polishing other people's songs.
Right. Yeah, but it's fun. It's really the discipline of having to come up with a song every month.
Oh, every month everybody has to come up with a song.
Yeah, it's sometimes odder and more in the
breeze. And so you play the songs for each other, then you give each other critiques on it?
Exactly.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's kind of cool.
It's really cool.
I almost wish I wrote songs.
Yeah. And then you come back the next month and show the changes that you've made and play a new one. And so
that sounds very cool.
It keeps songs in the hopper. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
God, what am I missing out on? I need to start a new band or get a new thing going.
Right.
No, that's all I need. I swore I wasn't going to be in five bands, and here I am in it again.
Yeah, well,
but we're running out of time. But I want to hear another song.
Okay, I'm gonna play.
What else you got for us?
I got a song that I was listening to a podcast late at night during COVID. I started listening to podcasts to help me sleep, and because people talk and you got to fall asleep. But
right.
There was a podcast about people splitting up after long marriages.
Uh-huh.
But they weren't young people. These were people in their 70s or 80s. And
wow, why at that point?
And you never know where the seed, as Josh would say, the seed for the song is going to come. There was one old guy that said, for 35 years she cooked my meals and took care of me, and I came home, and one day in a couple minutes she told me she was leaving. He said, and she didn't even make my dinner. So this is called 2 minutes. Okay,
2 minutes live here in the studio with Randy Burrows here on 91.3.
Well, headlights blind me, cast a shadow behind me of a man I no longer recognize. As you back down the driveway, I can't make out your face, but I still see the resign in your eyes. And I catch your silhouette lighting up a cigarette in a pause that lasts for years. I read your stop as a sign that you're changing your mind. Turns out you were just changing gears. Oh, 2 minutes was all you gave, the time it takes to boil an egg. 2 minutes shorter than this song. 2 minutes to say goodbye. Two batches of minute rice. 2 minutes and you were gone. Well, tail lights recede and suddenly those brake lights bleed. Are you throwing your plans into reverse? Ah, but amidst my wishful thinking, a single bulb starts blinking. You take a turn for the worst. Oh, 2 minutes was all you gave, the time it takes to boil an egg. 2 minutes shorter than this song. 2 minutes to say goodbye. Two batches of minute rice. 2 minutes and you are gone. If you don't know by now, was all you said. Like every canary in the mine was long dead. I suppose we burned to ashes while I was looking through rose glasses. And all this time you'd been seeing red. Oh, 2 minutes was all you gave, the time it takes to boil an egg. 2 minutes shorter than this song. 2 minutes to say goodbye. Two batches of minute rice. 2 minutes and you were gone. 2 minutes to say goodbye. Two slices of minute pie. 2 minutes and you were gone.
Randy Burrows live here in the studio, 91.3. What was that one again?
It's called 2 Minutes.
2 Minutes. Well, let me tell you something. Don't let anybody ever tell you you don't sing well or write good songs, because you do. Those were all three of them songs were just fine, and your vocals are just right on. So I'm really happy to hear you. One question. If you could have written one song out of all the songs in this world so far, what would that song have been?
Oh, boy. That's a really good question. I like, you know... Crazy by Willie Nelson comes to mind. In Spite of Ourselves by John Prine is one of my favorite songs, probably.
Not favorite, but what? God, I wish I wrote that.
That's a really good question.
You know, and everybody, you know, it's funny because people, it's that. They have to think, or sometimes they know the answer before I'm asking, before they're done asking.
There's so many.
It's funny.
You know,
that's fine. So many. But you gave me a couple. I'm good with that.
Okay, good.
Some people know immediately, you know. Yeah. Like I've asked people, it's like, what song would you wish you could have imagined? Right. I mean, or something like that. They know immediately. But anyway, where can people catch you? Where are you playing next?
Okay, well, so next, I got an open mic coming up on the 18th at Starling.
Of November at Starling.
Yeah. And then... Josh and I play together as a donkey and an ass. That's our duo. And I think we'll be at the Starling in December.
Okay.
I'm not sure of the date yet.
How do people follow you? On Randall Burrows Music?
Randy Burrows Music on Instagram.
And on the Book of Faces?
Randall Burrows.
Okay.
And I've got a website, randyburrows.com, got some videos with some music on it.
So people can stalk you there if they're interested.
Exactly.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Randy, thank you very much for coming in and taking the time. I know you probably had other things going on. We appreciate the time you spent here.
My pleasure.
Next week, we do not have a guest yet. We had a cancellation. So tune in next week, and you'll be as surprised as I am as to who we have in the studio. Yeah, we'll see who we can come up with. Anyway, I've been your host, James Marshall Berry. This has been the New Old Show. Thank you very much for tuning in. We will catch you again next week. Talk to you soon.